Sponge cake and the ginger and a little bit of sugar. About a quarter to half cup, depending on the sweetness of the fruit. It depends on that, and then that goes into. Oh, the sponge cake was very hard to get. It's out of season now.
Yeah.
Very difficult. But we managed it. Oh, we'll put five.
Two cups of green tea.
Yeah, for the juice. Melon and ginger
drink.
Soft drink, yeah.
Oh, that sounds lovely.
With green
tea. From something.
To say it's not that bad.
Yeah.
Someone's been through that before.
Yeah, I suppose.
It's very fragrant. Mm. I had a mint leaf, so that makes it all the better.
Yeah.
But I can't help falling in love with you. Shall
this is the ice cream?
Yeah, this is the coffee.
It's 1 can of?
A can of ideal milk or evaporated milk.
Mm.
And you heat that up first. Skin just forms on top, and you'll see the bubbles will go to the side as you're heating it. It's not actually boiling, it's just like simmering.
No sugar in
it? No, because the condensed milk is sufficient. If I leave it any longer now, it just makes it. The whole can of milk. In there and give it a stir. And a nice good stir. It's got a nice creamy color. You can also, like, if you've got like Earl Grey tea or, you know, any other lavender or rosehip tea, I think you get those different lemon teas. Mm. Not lemon, but Five Roses got a nice variety of tea.
Mm.
You can even use that when you're heating up the milk to give your ice cream a darker shade. You can do that as well.
Freeze it.
Yeah, you just freeze it. You've got to do this like the day before, otherwise it won't freeze on time because of the cream and the condensed milk. It takes a bit more time than the normal ice cream. Tupperware molds.
Mm.
I took out 3 to see if it's going to work. This 2 here I'll take out while you are, you know. You just dip it in hot water.
Okay.
And it comes out quite easily.
Okay.
So they're very old Tupperware molds. I think it's about 25, 30 years old. I was a Tupperware fan at one time.
Oh, okay.
Now not so much.
Okay, so you just put them in the mold and
then
freeze.
Yeah, then this here, this little handle's got little holes.
Mm.
When you stick it in, then the ice cream comes together between the holes and then it stays on.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't come off.
Okay.
Unfortunately, you have to eat the ice cream here because I need these little things.
Oh, okay.
Wait for about a minute probably. And then it should come out. There's it. Put a little bit of ilachi and a little bit of pista on it. And there we are. I didn't arrange it very nicely, but they melt very quickly because of the milk content.
Oh, lovely.
An ice cream machine or just straight into the mold?
I mixed it in there's the other
excitement stores or somewhere. I can't remember, yeah. But the plastic wasn't as good as this.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
it wasn't really solid.
Yeah. This has a nice, like a bendy to it.
Somebody still has this, probably.
Surely to the sea, darling, so it goes.
She accompanied it with, on the side as part of the drink, she made this really lovely, what is it? It was a ginger and melon iced tea concoction, very tasty with a bit of mint in it, really complemented her main meal. For dessert, we were treated to a lovely homemade Malai ice cream. Auntie Hawa poured them into little sucker molds and that was served. It was an excellent ending to the meal because it was a light dessert, yet at the same time, because it was like malai in the mixture, it was very rich, but not too rich where it becomes sort of like sickly sweet. It was just the perfect balance of pista and ilachi and the milk. It was just a really nice way to end off the meal, especially because there was a rice component. You don't want your dessert to be too overpowering, and I think it was just a good choice. And all in all, I give her dessert a 10.
The drink we had was melon mixed with green tea and mint. The dessert was just my absolute favorite. It was an ice cream which would go very well on summer days. It was a burfi kulfi. It was presented very well. The taste was yummy. It sat very well. The kids would love it. It was very, very soothing for the taste buds. My overall score for that is a 9.7.
The juice was spun speck. It was pretty. I couldn't finish it all, so I scored a 6 and I gave it an yeah. I like the burfi ice cream thing. It was delicious. It looked easy to make, and I give it a 9.
All in all, it was very nutritious. It was a well-balanced meal. I know that my kids would love that because it's very nutritious and something that's child-friendly, easy on the taste buds. The overall experience today was fantastic. It was just an absolute honor to be at one of these events, to be judging it. The atmosphere was very hospitable. We fitted well in together. We blended well. It was an absolute honor and a pleasure. My overall experience is a 9.6.
And now for the general diagnosis. I thought that Auntie Hawa had really put together a very well thought out meal plan. None of her ingredients kind of dominated or overpowered. Like our starter with the egg and noodle was sort of like a nice vegetarian start to a meal, to a main that was sort of dominated by the chicken. So there was a nice sense of balance between a light starter, like a wholesome and hearty main, and then capped off with a nice creamy dessert that wasn't too rich, but had just the right amount of sweetness to bring the whole meal together. All in all, Auntie Hawa's meal was just what the doctor would prescribe for a happy tummy.
The score.
And her total score is 10. 10 out of 10.
Fools rush.
Oh, I always want to enjoy the summer, baby. Okay, no offense to all the lunch date hostesses, but for me the highlight is always the Ask Nani Machoria plate from Nani Bazaar. Jazakallah, Nani.
Would it be a